10, 661 North 11th Street. Has notice for this appeal been given?
Yes.
Would you swear in our zoning officer, please?
Do you swear the testimony about to give will be the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth?
I do.
Okay, thank you. Mr. Price?
Thanks. I'll put some exhibits into the record, and I have some questions to ask the applicant after they're sworn. Exhibit number one is the notice. Exhibit number two is proof of publication of the notice. Exhibit number three is proof of posting of the notice. Exhibit number four is the application, including all of its attachments. And exhibit number five is the zoning ordinance of the City of Reading as amended. We'll swear Mr. Umberto Grande in.
Are you here, Mr. Grande? Okay.
Yes, I'm here.
All right.
Do you swear the testimony about to give will be the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth?
I do.
Mr. Grande, I'm going to ask you a couple of questions because I think I can get to the heart of this matter pretty quickly. Do you and your wife own 661 North 11th Street?
Excuse me?
That's correct.
I can't hear.
That's correct. It's a JJJR Apartments, LLC.
Okay. And there were three apartments in that property, correct?
That is correct.
And did you purchase it before or after the fire?
I purchased before. I had it for a year before.
And at the time of the fire, there was three apartments at the property, correct?
That is correct.
And the fire destroyed a substantial portion of the building, but the city wasn't able to determine whether it was more than 50%, correct?
That's correct, yes.
And all you're asking to do is to keep your non-conforming status and have the building declared that the use was not abandoned. You didn't convert it to two apartments or to a single family home, correct?
No.
Okay, so you just want to be able to put back what was there at the time of the fire.
Correct.
And do you have plans to do that within the next 6 months to a year if you're granted permission?
Yes, even sooner.
Okay. I don't have any other questions for Mr. Grande.
Okay. Do any members of the board have any questions?
No, it's clear.
Okay. Anybody in the audience have any questions? All right. Any questions from Emily?
No questions.
Okay. Mr. Price?
Nope, no more.
Okay.
Thank you, Mr. Grande.
Thank you so much, guys.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
All right, we'll issue a decision at next month's meeting. You need not be here. A decision will be mailed to you. You win the award for shortest hearing of the year.
I feel for you guys after that last situation.
All right,
thank you.
Okay. I'll grab the next applicant then.
Yeah, now we're going to do appeal 2023-13, 715 Clinton Street. Would you swear in the applicant, please?
I think she went to get them.
Okay. Where? Oh, okay. You want to swear in the applicant?
All right. Will you please raise your right hand to the applicant? Do you swear the testimony about to give will be the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth?
I do.
Thank you. Your full name?
Lauren McDaniel.
Spell that.
McDaniel.
Thank you.
And I think I forgot to swear in Emily to see if notice for this appeal has been given.
Do you swear the testimony about to give will be the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth?
I do. And notice has been given.
Okay. Thank you very much. Mr. Price, you need to enter your exhibits.
Yep. I'll put some exhibits into the record. Exhibit number one is the notice. Exhibit number two is proof of publication of the notice. Exhibit number three is proof of posting of the notice. Exhibit number four is the application, including all of its attachments. And exhibit number five is the zoning ordinance of the City of Reading as amended.
Okay. Are you represented by counsel or are you representing yourself?
I am representing the applicant and the owner of the property. I'm with a company called Steelworks Construction.
Okay.
And what is your name, Em? McDaniel?
Yes, Lauren McDaniel.
All right. Why don't I ask you a couple questions if I can? Sure. All right. At the front of the application, there's a photograph of a large, looks like mid-20th century industrial building. Is that the subject property?
Yes, it is.
And do you know what it was previously used for?
Yes, it was previously approved for the following uses, including manufacturer, display, and sale of art, furniture, and artifacts, a cafe and restaurant, a banquet hall to be operated for an individual event with a private caterer, and for a 450 square foot living area in which a sole artist can reside and work for no longer than 30 days in a calendar year.
That was the prior zoning relief for that?
Yes, correct.
And your client has purchased it since then, or were they the same people that got that approval?
No, they purchased the property in September of 2022. The deed was made a part of our application.
And they want to turn it into a child daycare center, is that correct?
Yes, that is correct.
And those other uses would not be occurring at the property?
The banquet hall use would continue, that is their intention. And then a portion of the first floor they would like to make into the daycare facility. The remaining portion of the first floor, they still don't have the exact details of how they intend to use that space, but we would be prepared to come back at that point when we have more information.
Okay, so the living area is gone and the sale of art and furniture and all that stuff's probably gone as well, correct?
Correct, yes.
Okay, and how many children would be at this daycare center?
In our application, we included that it could potentially accommodate up to 50 children based on PA code regulations. I don't believe it is the intention of the applicant to have that many children, but a maximum of 50 children could be accommodated.
And there's off-street parking and the property is secured with the fence, is that correct?
That is correct.
And the owners of the daycare know that they'd have to provide a sufficient space outside for outdoor play for the children?
Yes, that is correct. We did provide a plot plan showing the location where an approximately 480 square foot outdoor play area will be located. We will be removing approximately 5 parking spaces to accommodate that requirement.
And would this be in operation from like 6 in the morning till 6 at night, or what were the hours of operation?
We propose likely no earlier than 7 a.m. and likely no later than 6 p.m., but it may even be more like 8 to 5. Yeah, most likely 8 to 5, but potentially slightly earlier or later.
But 6 to 7 would give you ample flexibility.
Yeah, I don't think there's any. Yeah, would be more than enough time.
And are there going to be card-coded doors and security cameras and things like that?
I don't know if that was the intention.
Yeah,
no. I do not believe so. The facility is secured by a fence, but there is a security system and camera, yes.
But there is a security system and camera, okay. In the general neighborhood of Clinton Street, what's near there?
I don't actually know what all those. There is a school there. It is the MC district, so it is all commercial properties around there.
Who's talking?
The owner of the property is here with me as well.
Yeah, we can't have that because you speak or she speaks, but we can't have that.
Fair enough.
We can't take two people at one time.
I can speak to the general area. Since I went out to post, not sure if it'd be okay.
Who's that?
It's me, Emily.
Okay, Emily. Yeah. Why don't you testify about what's out there?
Okay. There are some commercial uses around there, but the right at the end of Clinton Street, there is a park. I don't remember the name of it. There is also Olivet's, and there is a school nearby, I believe.
There's out. Can you repeat it?
A school, the Olivet's, Olivets.
Thank you.
All right. And all right. I don't have any other questions for Ms. McDaniel.
Okay. All right, board members, let's start with Charlie. Any questions?
No, I have no questions.
Tom, questions?
No questions.
Jeff? Question.
Just real quick, the banquet facilities of no intersection with the daycare. In other words, completely, they're walled off somehow. Just to briefly talk about that.
Yeah, the banquet facility is located on the second floor of the building, and the daycare center will be located on the first floor.
That's about enough. Sure. Thank you.
Okay, Mr. Harst. Questions?
No questions.
All right. Just a couple of things. Mr. Price touched on them. I don't really have questions. I just want to remind you that you need the play area. You need to keep the students and or the children and any other uses separated. And you need to have a very viable security system there. So, and also a safe drop area. Has the applicant designed a drop area?
Yeah, I believe it's already set up with the location for drop off.
Thank you. All right, anybody in the audience have any questions? Seeing none, anybody for the application? Seeing none, anybody against the application? Seeing none, anything you would like to add, Emily?
We have already discussed it about just needing a floor plan of exactly where on the first floor daycare will be located once the permit goes to be reviewed and approved, denied, depending on your decision.
Okay, Mr. Price?
I have nothing further, sir.
All right, applicant, you have anything else you'd like to add?
No.
Okay, thank you.
Can I just get your address, the applicant?
I'm sorry, can I ask the applicant, because I put my address as the representative.
Yeah. Did you give an address as, I need your information.
430 North Front Street in Wormleysburg, Pennsylvania.
And the name of the company?
Steelworks Construction.
Thank you.
Yes.
Okay. That concludes this appeal. We'll issue a decision at next month's meeting. You need not be here. The decision will be mailed to you. And we thank everybody for your efforts. And we'll move
thank
on
you very
to
much.
The next hearing to the next appeal. Okay. The next matter before us is appeal 2023-11. It's 411 South 14th Street. Would you swear in our zoning officer, please?
You swear the testimony I'm about to give will be the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth?
I do.
Thank you.
Okay, has notice for this appeal been given?
It has.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Price.
Thanks. I'll put some exhibits into the record. Exhibit one, number one is the notice. Exhibit number two is proof of publication of the notice. Exhibit number three is proof of posting of the notice. Exhibit number four is the application, including all of its attachments. And exhibit number five is the zoning ordinance of the city of Reading as amended.
Okay, thank you. And it looks like Mr. Cuck is going to represent the applicant, and either that or it's his evil twin brother. I'm not sure which. But anyway, you want to enter your appearance, and if you're going to have somebody testify, we'll have them sworn in at this time.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Members of the board, again, Mark Cuck on behalf of the applicant, ILD Properties, LLC, represented by Mercedes Davis. She is an agent with Pagoda Realty. Okay. We can go ahead and have her sworn, please.
All right. Would you swear in the applicant, please?
Please raise your right hand. You swear the testimony you're about to give will be the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth?
I do.
Thank you.
Okay, go ahead, Mr. Cuck.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman, members of the board. So what I have this evening is Mercedes is the owner of a property through her entity, ILD Properties, LLC at 411 South 14th Street. Mercedes, you are a realtor with Pagoda Realty, is that right?
Yes, I do.
And so you've been sworn, and are you an investor in certain properties in the city?
Yes, I do.
And did you say yes, you are?
Yes.
Okay. And did you acquire 411 South 14th Street in the R3 district?
Yes.
And did you buy it as an investment?
Yes.
And so is it a pretty big house?
Yes.
When you bought the property, was it in a state of disrepair and a mess?
Oh, yes. A mess.
And what did you do with it? Did you clean it up?
I clean, I repair, I paint, I change the floor. I expend a lot of money.
So what you believed at the time was that the actual building was already converted to a two unit. Was that what you thought was going on?
Absolutely.
As you worked your way through the process, did you determine that it actually is not permitted or approved as a two unit?
I had my doubt, you know, I thought that was two units.
And so after you did a significant amount of work to clean it up, about how much money did you spend to convert this property? I'm sorry, not to convert, but to clean up the property, do the flooring, do the walls, painting windows, that kind of stuff.
From 30 to 35,000. And I am still expending money because it was a mess, completely a mess.
So you invested about 30 to 35,000. Yep. Into the property after you acquired it.
Absolutely.
And the concern and why you're here this evening is it's in the R3 district and you are not allowed to convert a single family residence into a two unit. Is that your understanding?
Yeah.
And so under the circumstances, with the property being set up already as a two unit, and I want to be clear, you did not do that, right?
No, I didn't.
But you have invested a significant amount into repairs and updating and cleaning up the property.
Yes.
And so at this point, you are requesting from the board permission to convert the single family into a two unit. Is that right?
Yes.
And you are looking for the board's approval to do that. And if they're willing to do so, will you obtain all permits and approvals necessary for that?
Yes, this is what I want to do. I always do the right thing
and
for the book.
And so, Emily, could you put up for me the floor plans, please, for the board?
One second here.
Thank you. Thank you, Emily. So I think we're looking at the first floor plan. Is that right?
This is the first floor.
All right. And so, Mrs. Diaz-Davis, you actually had, I'm sorry, go ahead. They're at the top there, second floor.
Sorry, they're both listed as second floor. So,
second floor is two bedrooms.
Yeah, second floor is a two bedroom unit. All right. So, it's not coming up.
This was the original that was submitted. Let me pull up the one you just sent me today.
Yeah, the one I sent you would be the clean version.
Okay.
So Mrs. Davis, while she's pulling that up, and the board will see this in just a minute, but the first floor, you have that proposed as a one bedroom unit, am I right?
Yeah.
And the board has heard some fairly extensive testimony tonight about the sizes of these units. In that particular instance, the one bedroom unit requires 530 square feet, is that right? And you have proposed, 550 square feet. And you have proposed this first floor unit, which is a one bedroom unit, to have 489 square feet, am I right?
Yes.
And so that's an existing first floor unit, correct?
Yes.
You didn't change the floor plan or anything like that.
Not at all.
But you have done replaced flooring, you've replaced painting, and you've replaced windows.
Yes.
All right. And then when you look at the second floor plan, the next page, please, that has a two bedroom unit in it. Am I right?
Yes.
And the requirement for that under the code is 700 square feet, but this unit only has 486 square feet by the city's calculation, right?
Yeah.
Would you propose to the board that you would put no more than one couple as tenants on each floor, is that right?
Right, absolutely.
And do you believe that each of these floors has enough square footage to be safe and comfortable?
Yes.
And again, you've indicated you would comply with any codes necessary to make these comply, right?
Absolutely. Yeah.
Especially with the International Building Code, we meet that to the best of your knowledge.
Oh, yes.
All right. With respect to parking, there's a garage to the rear of the property, am I right?
Yes.
And that garage, do you think it could house two cars in it or just one?
Is this a big, a two small car? That would be absolutely fine.
So you think you can have two small vehicles?
Small car, yeah, vehicle.
And is it your belief that there is plenty of parking on the street now?
Yes.
So if the requirement is three spaces, you're asking the board to approve the conversion to allow basically the parking that exists in the garage that's there?
Yes.
Do you believe that the relief you're requesting is detrimental to any of the surrounding property owners?
No.
Do you think that the amount of money that you've invested into the property and you will continue to invest in the property will increase the value of this property and of other properties?
Absolutely.
No further questions for Mrs. Davis.
I just have one. While she's been doing all this work, has she been doing some of it herself there?
Have you been doing the work yourself there or hiring contractors?
I did some myself, but mostly somebody.
And when you were there, did any of your neighbors on either the left or right side of this home come and complain to you about the apartment or the parking?
No.
Okay.
No.
And do you know how long it's been a two-unit building?
So what he's asking you is, you had said to me that you thought that it had been converted not by the last owner, but by the owner before that?
Yes, and yes.
Can you tell them why you think that?
Because two kitchen, one upstairs, one in the first floor, the bathroom upstairs, in the bathroom in the first floor. And you can see, especially in the kitchen, the place that they had the stove, the electric stove.
So it's already laid out as a two unit. And the prior owner, it was vacant for quite some time. Is that right?
Yes.
And it was full with a lot of trash?
Yes.
So you believe that the person who owned it before you, they had died, but you think that the owner before that's the one who made the changes?
The people that was living there for a long, long time.
Two owners ago.
Yes, I think so.
I have a quick question. How many electric meters and gas meters are there? Do you know?
One meter.
Okay. All right. Mr. Price?
No, that's the question I was going to ask.
Okay. All right. All right.
If you looked at the, were any of the appliances still in the kitchens when you got there?
No. No.
They had been taken out?
Yeah. They had so much garbage, so many, container with picture and you name it.
Well, I was just trying to get an idea how old you estimated the electric range or gas range. Was it 20 years old or 30 years old?
No idea.
How about the bathroom fixtures in the bathroom? Are they from the 1960s, 70s, 80s?
Oh, that were very, very old. Very old.
In both bathrooms?
Yeah. Yeah, okay. Very old.
All right. I don't know.
And messy, really bad. That was bad.
All right, thank you.
Okay, Mr. Jones, any questions?
No, I have none.
Tom?
Just one thing, looking over the report, am I wrong or am I right? Did the applicant buy this at a tax sale?
Did you buy this property at tax sale or did you buy it at an arm's length transaction?
Repeat again.
So did you buy this property at tax sale or did you buy it from another seller at arm's length transaction?
No, I bought from the guy that owned the last one, that he owned the place for a couple months.
So it was not a tax sale?
No.
Emily, did I misread something on the report? I could be wrong. Did you think it was a tax sale or didn't you know?
So I didn't type up the staff report, but that wouldn't be something that we would look into. I did pull up the listing online, and it looks like it was purchased. There was a sale in January 2022 and then another sale June of 2022. So
I'm looking at the deed right now. It's part of the application. The deed is from a couple by the name of Morales and Velasquez, husband and wife, to ILD Properties on June 10 of 22.
Yeah, so that's not something that we would look into how the sale was made.
It's not a tax sale. Mrs. Davis, what did you pay for the property?
How much I paid?
Yeah.
$69,000.
She paid $69,000 for the property.
And part of the money, that was, you know, cash.
Anything else, Tom?
No, no, I am interpreting what Emily had given me when I looked at it was a deed there, and I was probably ignorant on that. So I'll take your word for what you say, Mark.
Okay. Jeff, questions?
No questions. No questions.
Bill, questions?
No questions.
And I don't have any at this point either.
I do have one question.
Oh, go ahead.
If I can. The attic space, is that accessible from that second floor unit? Is that part of the second floor unit?
Yeah. Bueno.
So she's asking you if that attic is to be part of the second floor or just storage?
Storage.
But so it's accessible from the second floor.
But it's not going to be part of the unit. It would like both tenants would be accessible to that, or is that just for the second
floor? No. No, I didn't fix the audio or anything like that. No.
Who would have access?
Would not be part of the second unit.
No, my question is, would only the second floor tenant have access to that attic, or is that a communal attic for both tenants?
So the first floor tenant won't have the right to use.
No.
Okay, so, seeing that. Our definition for habitable floor area would include, you could include the attic space as part of habitable area. So including the attic space with that second floor unit, they actually would have sufficient habitable area for a two bedroom unit.
Thank you very much, Emily. That was
thank helpful. You, Emily.
Thank you.
So Emily's the only one who did the equations tonight with all these teachers.
Did a good job. Right. Thank you.
Okay. Now, anybody in the audience have any questions of this applicant? Seeing none. Anybody in the audience want to testify for granting the application? Seeing none. Anybody want to testify against granting the application? Seeing none. Okay. We thank all of you, and unless somebody has something that they would like to add, like Mr. Cuck or whatever, I'll close this appeal and we'll issue a decision at next month's meeting. You need not be here. It will be mailed to you.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for your time. I'll tell my evil twin that he shouldn't have gone so long earlier. I apologize for that.
All right.
Have
a good evening. That'll be fine. Just warn him about that. And Emily wins the math award for this evening.
Thank you.
All right. Thank you, everybody. All right. And our last appeal for this evening is 2023-12, 733 Lancaster Avenue. Is the applicant present? Oh, let's swear Emily in first. Go ahead.
Do you swear the testimony about to give will be the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth?
I do.
Has notice for this appeal been given?
It has.
Okay, thank you. Mr. Price?
Thanks. I'll put some exhibits into the record. Exhibit number one is the notice. Exhibit number two is proof of publication of the notice. Exhibit number three is proof of posting of the notice. Exhibit number four is the application, including all of its attachments. And exhibit number five is the zoning ordinance of the city of Reading as amended.
Okay. And it looks like Ms. London is going to enter her appearance, and then we'll swear in whoever you want to have testify.
Yes. Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I'll have two witnesses tonight, George Ortiz, owner of American Barber and Beauty School, and Mark Christman, who designed the plans. All of the exhibits were submitted with the Zoning Hearing Board application. I'll enter my appearance, Joan London, L-O-N-D-O-N, at Kaslov Stout, 2640 Westview Drive, why I'm missing for the applicant, American Barber and Beauty Academy.
You're okay. Welcome to do an offer of proof tonight.
Mr. Yeah, we need to swear in your witnesses, though, in case they testify. Yes.
Will you both please raise your right hand? You swear the testimony you're about to give will be the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth?
I do.
Okay. Now, go ahead.
All right. to give you a brief offer of proof, and Mr. Ortiz can fill in any gaps. Mr. Ortiz would testify that the property is owned by Redding Investments. He's a tenant with consent to proceed, and the consent of the owner was submitted with the application. American Barber and Beauty Academy is a barber and beauty school. It is a licensed cosmetology school, licensed in good standing, and all instruction is by license.
I don't think he's in here.
We're getting some background from somebody.
Yeah. Hey, I know the background. I'm in a quiet room, so it's not coming from here. All right, I'll try that again. The school, American Barber and Beauty Academy, is operated by Mr. Ortiz. It is licensed in good standing with the State Board of Cosmetology, license and instructions by licensed cosmetologists. There is a demand for the programs that are offered by the school. It is an existing use. There was a variance granted in 2019, and a copy of the decision was attached to the zoning application. But there's a great deal of demand for the programs and for the services offered. And in order to stay competitive and keep the school viable, there must be up-to-date classroom space, especially salon and shop space and classroom space. The addition would be of approximately 585 gross square feet of space. Mr. Crispin prepared the plans, and he will run us through those plans.
How much square footage is the barber school using now?
Mr. Ortiz, can you?
Yes, it's a little over 10,000 square feet.
So we're talking like a 5% increase in square footage to accommodate your already existing business, correct?
Did you say 5%?
Yes.
10,000 square feet, and you're expanding it 585 feet. It's 5.8%.
Yes, so that's right.
Okay. And any of your neighbors have any objection to you expanding your school?
Not that was presented to me, no.
Let me ask the board, Ms. Lund. Does the board need to hear any more testimony with respect to this de minimis expansion?
I don't. Mr. Jones?
No.
Mr. Fox?
No.
Mr. Gattone?
No, I know the place.
Okay, yeah. Mr. Harsht?
No.
The only question I have is I drove by there the other day and there was like 20 women in gowns standing in front of your barbershop. What was that about?
We have ceremonies pretty often. They graduate individually, so and we celebrate them individually. So yes. You'll see a graduate and family and friends and, you know, class.
I thought it was prom stuff or something. I was just curious. I had to know.
Yeah. Also, on the issue of parking, in case there are any questions, the staff report confirmed that there is sufficient parking with the school and the buildings with which it's associated, and there'll be no need for any additional parking. This is mainly to serve current students and keep the school viable. There's no encroachments into any setbacks either, which is also confirmed by the zoning staff report. Do you need Mr. Crispin's testimony on to showing the plans and renderings? They were attached with the application.
Now, he's testified before. They're in the record because they're part of the application. So I don't think we need his testimony unless the board does.
I don't think any of us do. No, that's fine. And you know, it's a very nice facility, and it's a great addition to that part of town. So, you know.
Thank you.
All right. Is there anybody in the audience who has any questions? Seeing none. Anybody want to testify for the granting of the application? Seeing none. Anybody want to testify against granting the application? Seeing none. Okay. So unless Ms. London or anybody else has anything to offer, we'll close this appeal. Emily, I don't think I asked you if you had any questions or comments.
No questions.
Okay. Mr. Price?
Just to the board, I'll have my secretary coordinate an executive session workshop.
Okay. And Ms. London, anything you want to add or?
Nothing further. Thank you for your attention.
Okay. You're more than welcome. So that closes the May meeting for the Zoning Hearing Board for the City of Reading. We'll see you on the second Wednesday of June and get out and enjoy the weather. Thank you, everybody.
Good night.
Thank you.
Good night.
Thank you for your patience.
Recording stopped.